back with a very exciting updated video, and I sound like I am on the news or something like that. But anyway, I am back with an updated video on the brand McAdams, and we are now 10 days into McAdams and we are very excited, and I don't know what I'm going to say now. I haven't really thought this video through. Hello friends, and we are back with a pixie. Oh my goodness, come on. Hello friends, and we are back with another very exciting pixie. Come on, I need to do this video. Bonk. Hello friends, and we are back with another very exciting video for you guys to see, and we have an updated video on pixie. We have an updated video on our food McAdams. You're a cheeky monkey, aren't you? Oh, pixie, your paw was down my top. Look at that tail going. You're just so excited. Why are you licking your lips? Is it because the food's out? Is it? Oh, you're going to give me a bruise in the face. My goodness, she's in play mode. I'm doing a video. Playtime later. What have you got? What's she got? The bird. Look at the tail go. It's video time. Playtime later. You?
home. You're not getting any more. You're just washing your face on my nice clean carpet. Thanks, Pixie. That is a face of a dog who loves their breakfast.
And we are back with another very exciting updated video for you guys, and we are doing an update on our brand new food, McAdams. Now, we've been on this food for, I want to say, let me think, we got the food last Monday, so that'll be 7, 8, 9, 10 days now. Sorry, Roxy's just having a drink. Slurp, slurp, slurp. Yes, so we have been on McAdams. This is the 10th day we have been on McAdams, and so far, so good. We did have a hiccup kind of mid into our 7 days, our first... No, that's Pixie having a drink. Now, you're done. Good. We did have a hiccup in the first week of trying McAdams. Now, I used to rotate flavours, breakfast and tea time, but with some help from YouTubers, and some comments people had made, they kind of explained to me that they're maybe holding out for their favourite flavour, and by doing one flavour breakfast, one flavour tea time, then if they don't eat their breakfast, they're maybe holding out for the flavour that they get at tea time. So I decided to feed the one flavour all the time, and we've done that for the last couple of brands that we've been on. So I wanted to try the chicken of McAdams first. So this is the one that we tried first. And I want to say, we started that on the Monday, and I want to say kind of Friday and Saturday, they didn't eat their breakfast at all. They went up and they had a sniff and they just weren't interested, and I thought, here we go, only 7 days into starting McAdams, we are having issues. But I had just recently upped their food because they were literally scoffing what they had and they were still hungry, so I had literally upped it like the Wednesday and Thursday, and thought maybe that was just too much for them to have, that they wouldn't eat their breakfast to Friday and the Saturday, because if they didn't eat their breakfast, I lifted it and put it back, like put it away. So something tells me they were still full in the morning and not that hungry, because I only give them like a wee drop at breakfast, and then the kind of majority of their meal is at tea time. So maybe the tea time was just too much for them. So we're back down to the original weight of what we were feeding them, the original amount, which is 2 quarter scoops. So they get a quarter scoop for breakfast, they get a quarter scoop for tea time, which works out about 65 grams. And I know the recommended amount on the packet is about 95 grams, which I have tried. I've even tried 80 grams, and it's proven to be too much for them. So we are kind of at a happy amount of about 65, possibly 70, because sometimes I do like a heap scoop, and sometimes they get a wee bit extra. So with that, they have been really happy on that, and I did want to try the other flavour. So after they didn't eat breakfast, I tried the salmon and chicken, which we have been on now for, well, it'll be a week at the end of this week. Can I ask you what you're doing? Are you making a mess? Mm-hmm. Anyway, as I was saying, so that'll be a week at the end of this week that we have been on salmon and chicken, and so far so good. They have not missed a meal, they have scoffed every meal, they've not even left anything, they've totally like licked the bowls clean, they've went to each other's bowls and licked them clean, and they look for more. So I am really happy that they like the salmon and the chicken, because they're not really a fishy dog. Like, they don't like fish, they're not fond of fish. It's not that they don't like it, they're not fond of fish. So I am really happy. So we have been on this one for just about a week now, which means that I can't tell how long a bag is going to last me, because if I stick with this bag, then when I started this bag and I finish this bag, then I can tell how long it's going to last me. But I was hoping to do that with the chicken, but it didn't really work out. But so far, so good. They've been on this chicken and salmon for about a week, almost a week now. And as I said, they love absolutely every single bite of it, which is really good. So I am now thinking about making my next order within the next week or two. I worked out that the girls should need about 6 kilograms a month, and that should leave me about, I don't know, maybe a couple of bits left over or whatever at the end of the month. And I think, what I don't know what I'm going to do is if I'm going to buy a big bag, because I've bought big bags before and they've went off and they've not eaten and I've wasted money. I know they have a return guarantee on this brand, which is really good, but I don't really want to go down that road. But I know that if I buy the wee individual boxes, then it's not going to be that much of a waste. Now, the only problem with that is I think it's going to be a wee bit more expensive, because I'm going to have to buy 3 boxes. What 3 boxes I'm going to buy, I don't know. I don't know whether or not to buy 2 chicken and a salmon, or 2 salmon and a chicken, or 3 salmon, because they're getting on really well with salmon just now. I don't know whether or not to order all 3 boxes at the one time, or order 2 boxes and then order like another box to last the end of the month, but then I'm having to pay postage on that box. So I'm trying to figure out all these things in my head, and to be honest, it's probably better just buying the 3 boxes and a winner, and that's me for a month. But then I run the risk of, you know, what if they go off it? I'm going to have to send all the boxes back, and I'm going to have to find another food. And I'm hoping that's not the case. Sorry about that. Some idiot out in the road racing up the road. Okay, anyway, as I was saying, so I don't know what I am going to do yet. I have about a week to 2 weeks to think about how I'm going to order the next lot, but I am excited to say that we are probably going to be making another order. It's not often we order the same food twice. It's been a while since we've done that, so I am really excited to order from McAdams again. I look forward to it. I look forward to seeing the health benefits that Pixie and Roxy are going to have on this food. And it has been good so far. I really like it. And the feedback from McAdams has been really good. The feedback that I've had online and from Instagram and YouTube and everything like that for trying this brand have been really, really good. It's not a brand that most people have heard of before, because it's something that I done when I looked into this brand was go onto YouTube and type in McAdams to see if anybody had reviews. I do that with every single dog food out there. I go on and look on YouTube. I want to see what people think of it. I want to see what it looks like. I want to see how their dog reacts to it. And McAdams didn't really have any of that on YouTube. So I'm really glad to be doing this video and this journey through McAdams food to share with everybody what it is like, because there could be somebody else that turns around and says, well, I want to try McAdams, but is there anything else? Is there anything out there on YouTube for letting me see what it visually looks like, how their dogs react and what the size is and what colour it is and all that kind of stuff. So I really look for these videos online when I'm trying new things, and I think other people do as well. And McAdams wasn't really on YouTube. I couldn't see any video reviews on McAdams on YouTube, and I am really glad that I have done it. I'm really happy with it, and I'm happy to vlog my journey through McAdams and let you guys see how they are enjoying their meal. So it is all good in the hoot. Isn't it, Pixie? All good in the hoot.
Yes.
Would you like one? While I've got it out, would you like one? Would you? Do you want to try a chicken again? They've not tried a chicken one since we've went on to the salmon. Do you? Okay. The only thing I have to say about my chicken box, I've had to tape it together because the box just fell apart. And I really like the box and I really like sitting the food in the box and scooping it out from the box. So I had to tape my box back together. So it's a bit wobbly at the moment, but never mind. Okay, now let me get a good size one in here because they're all broken up. Yes. Oh, it's a chicken. It's a chicken one. It's a chicken. Come here then. Give me a kiss. Go get him. Give me another one. Go get him. Another one. Kiss. Kiss. Go get him. Pixie, you want one? Come here. Give me a kiss. Come here, give me a kiss. Don't be so grumpy. Kiss.
Kiss. Give me a kiss.
There you go. Okay, so that was that eaten. I do want to try the chicken again, but I think I'm just so comfortable on the salmon and chicken, or the chicken and salmon, whatever way you want to pronounce it. But I think I feel too comfortable on that now because they're eating it. I'm afraid to go back to the chicken now in case that they don't eat the chicken, and then when I put the salmon back out, they don't eat the salmon. I'm probably overthinking a lot of things, but I just need to be confident and just stick with it and not turn around and be like, oh, they're not eating it, I need to change brand. I really like this brand. And I really want to give it a go and stick to it. So this is the scoop I used. It's just a wee baking scoop for like when you bake. And I got this from Asda. And it was like £1 or £1.50 for a set of like the full cup. So you get like a one cup, a half a cup, a quarter of a cup and a third of a cup. So I use the quarter cup scoop, which is this, and yes, it does look really tiny, but I just scoop out their food, which you've probably seen me do before in other videos. It's the same scoops, and I scoop their food out like that. And if I put it into a bowl, you can see how much that is. It doesn't look a lot, but it's what my girls are happy with, and they eat on that. Any more, I find that they tend not to eat or they leave, so that tells me that it's maybe just too much for them. But okay, that is our update. Now I'm still working on my blog post and my blog review for McAdams. I'm kind of taking my time with it because I'm adding wee bits in here and there, and I want to leave it long enough until the girls are 100% happy on this brand so that I can do a full blown review and how the girls absolutely love this food. So that blog post is still to come out, so keep your eyes peeled, it'll come out probably sometime within the next 2 weeks. And that is us, so yes! Hey, what are you looking at? Is it because both boxes are open and you want more? No, you need to save room for tea time. You're no wrong to go because it's almost 2 o'clock in the afternoon. You've got another 3 hours to go. No wrong. No wrong left. No. Okay, you guys. So thank you very much for watching. Give us a thumbs up if you like this video, leave me a comment, and as always, please subscribe to our channel, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye guys!